things sustainable, eco-friendly, and consumer conscious. If that is content you're interested in, please consider subscribing and liking this video because it really does help me with that YouTube algorithm. And it helps me with spreading my message of sustainability across a wider community as well. So today I'm bringing to you 5 books that have changed my life and set me on the course to lead this more sustainable lifestyle, and 5 more books that I am planning on reading in 2020. And I hope these books will kind of widen my horizons and widen my perspective on sustainability and sustainable lifestyle. So if you are interested in that, keep on watching. If you're one of those people who just don't know how to start with sustainable lifestyle, let me know if you have read any books that have helped you, because I would like to read them as well if I haven't read them. The reason I chose these 5 books is not because these are the only books that I have read about sustainability. I have read all the other ones that most other channels that are into this talk about, like the 101 Ways to Go, Zero Waste, the Bea Johnson book. But I thought for this video, I wanted to give you something else, some other new ideas to read about zero waste or being more sustainable. So that's why I chose these books. And the other thing I wanted to mention is I don't have these books with me. It's not because I didn't read them, it's because I always try to find books in the library. Of course, it's not possible right now. You can also swap with friends. And the next more sustainable thing you can do is go to a local bookshop and see if they can order it for you. Your last resort should be going on the big chain websites and getting those books from there. But even there, you can actually click the used box and you can get the book in great condition, but used. So you would be contributing to the circular economy. So let's get into all the books that I have read that have changed my mind. So the first book I want to talk about is this book, and it's called Sleeping Naked is Green by Vanessa Farquharson. This was the first book that I have read. I read it about 10 years ago. This was the first book that I read that was kind of about being green and being sustainable. And I believe this book started actually as a blog for Vanessa Farquharson. And later on, it kind of evolved into a book. So in this book, Vanessa takes you through small steps that she takes one by one to become more sustainable and more green in her life. And I found this book really accessible in terms of what changes can a person make in order to be more sustainable. So she starts with small things like cutting out subscriptions to paper magazines, and she goes all the way into getting rid of her car and starting a compost bin in her house. So it's really real things, and I found them really accessible and doable for my life. So if you are thinking of starting a more sustainable lifestyle, but you just don't know where to start, this is a great book to read first. The next book that kind of changed my perspective on life and everything is called The Dirty Life by Kristen Kimball. And this book is a really great read. It's a really interesting read. It's a memoir, so it's real events. And it talks about this lady from New York and how she meets this farmer, and all of a sudden she finds herself living on this farm, dealing with things that are very much the opposite of life in New York. It's a well-written memoir. It's really lighthearted, but you know, it's heavy in parts in that it's hard to live on a farm. But it's really cool to see how different people in the States live. And it's really cool to see how this life is possible, simplifying your life is possible. And this is what I took from it, how simple life is a happy life. And this is what I strive to have in my life as a result of reading that book. This book was recommended to me by my amazing friend, and she actually, not as a result of this book, she already had that in mind, but she actually now currently has a farm. She lives on a farm, she's a farmer, and she's incredible. The next book was actually recommended to me by an amazing librarian I used to work with, and it's called The Sustainable-ish Living Guide, right here, by Jen Gale. And this is another book that kind of talks about how every small change can make a bigger impact. And if you are one of those people who, again, want to live a more sustainable lifestyle, but you are just a little bit overwhelmed with a lot of the information that's out there, this book really breaks it down and puts it in very small steps, very doable things that people can do to reduce their impact on the environment. So I really enjoyed this book. It's a really fun book to read. So I recommend it if you just don't know where to start. The next book is also a fun read. It's called How Bad Are Bananas? The Carbon Footprint of Everything. So again, this book really breaks it down for everybody, what our footprint is like and how we can change that by doing things slightly differently. So it doesn't just talk about food, it talks about flights and vacations and clothing. So everything that people tend to consume, it talks about. So if you want a fun read that talks about carbon footprint of your own actions and purchases, this is a book to read for you. And the last book that has changed my mind about how the world really works is this book, The Shock Doctrine by Naomi Klein. So if you're watching this channel, you're probably familiar with Naomi Klein. This is not a fun book to read. It's a heavy book to read because it uncovers a lot of things in the world that are wrong and shouldn't be happening, but they are happening. It talks about how for every shock to the system, be it the environmental shock or some kind of shock to a country, follows up with corporations coming in and kind of saving the situation, but actually taking advantage of the situation. So it's not a fun read, but it's a very important read, and it really does open up your eyes to how environmental disasters cause a lot of not just damage to the environment, but actually damage to the social hierarchy in democracies. My journey with Naomi Klein started a long time ago with No Logo, and I read this, I think, when I was still in high school, and this is a book that talks about how corporations have become just like mega big and everything bad that comes from it. So you probably have read this book as well, and you, from this book, you can tell how persuasive Naomi Klein is and how she makes amazing arguments, and she just like opens up your eyes to the realities of the world. But it's also interesting to read. So it's heavy, but not really heavy. So now I want to move on to the 5 books that I'm planning on reading in 2020. And I think everybody should, because they hopefully will expand your knowledge about sustainable living and your understanding of how to be more sustainable. So number 1 book is called The Do-Gooder's Guide to Investing. And from the reviews, it seems that this is the book to read if you want to do in sustainable investment. And apparently it's a really light read and really funny. So I am really, really looking forward to reading this book, because I have read a lot of investment books and they are always written by like really serious guys in suits. And it seems that this book has a different language associated with it, and it's got a different mood to it. So I'm looking forward to reading this book. The next book I really, really want to read is this book, and I'm not gonna say the name, by Ashley Piper. The reviews are really good. I just wanna read it because of the name, but it seems like it has a lot of ideas in the book that I'm interested in. Again, this book talks about, I think, of things people can change that are little changes in their lives that can have way bigger impact in the world. The next book I really, really am looking forward to reading is called Fibershed. And the reason why I chose this book over Fashionopolis, which I will also link down below, because this book talks about really the lack of the relationship and knowledge we have about the fibers our clothes are made from. So it talks about the disconnect between what we think is a good fiber to actually the reality. For example, we all think that cotton is a great material to have your shirts made from, but actually it's extremely water heavy. So this is the kind of stuff I think this book talks about. Actually, fibers and more sustainable fabrics is something I'm really interested in learning about this year. If you want me to make a video on that, comment down below, because I'm really interested in what you think, because that's something I'm interested in. But what do you think? Are you interested in that? So let me know below. The next book I really, really want to read is actually recommended by Bill Gates, and it's called The Triumph of Seeds. This is kind of like a history book, sort of how seeds of different kinds have contributed to human life, have contributed to life on Earth, and where we're going with that. So I'm really interested in overall the concept of growing food is really interesting to me. So that's why I really want to read this book, to see what more I can learn about how agriculture has contributed to our world right now. And the last book that I'm really looking forward to reading, again, it's a Bill Gates recommendation. It's called Making the Modern World. This book really covers what it takes in terms of resources and energy to make the world as we are. And how can we keep going with a growing population, with our continuous urbanization and globalization, and where this can take us as a species, and is it actually sustainable? I don't expect that this last book will be an easy read, but the other four on the list of my wish list, they are definitely, I think, fun reads and easy, like lighthearted reads about serious stuff. So there you go, that's my list of 5 books that have changed my life and 5 books that are on my list to read. All of them have this common theme of being more sustainable as human beings. So I hope that you enjoy reading them if you choose to read them. Let me know also in the comments below if you have read any of these books or if you have other recommendations. I'm always open to book recommendations because it's my kind of new aim in life to read more books. I hope you join me next week on the channel, because next week I will talk about movies and shows that also have that theme of sustainability that I have watched that have also made a really big impact on me. Therefore, I would love to recommend them to you guys. So join me next time. But for now, thank you very much for watching, and I hope I will see you next time. Bye.